Good morning, my dear students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and good at home and you are doing your work nicely. Yes, my dear students, we have already started the new chapter, that is HCF. I have already explained you all that what HCF is all about, how we can find the highest common factor of any number. What is the common factor that we have discussed in multiples and factors also, and in the last video also I have discussed. Today we are going to move ahead with the same topic and we will learn more on that only. Today's topic is HCF by prime factorization method. What is this prime factorization method, my dear? Let's discuss. Prime factorization is to write a number as a product of its prime factor. There are two types of prime factorization. First, repeated division method, which I have explained you in the last class, where I have explained you that we used to divide a given number, given particular number, that much time, then we are not getting quotient as 1. Till that we will continue dividing. Second is building a factor tree method. So that both way I will discuss today in this class. See, first see some of the steps are written here. With that steps we can go on when we can find out the HCF by division method. The first question is written is, find the HCF of 34 and 24. So, step by step we will see first what we have to do, then we will do. Find the prime factors of the given number by the repeated division method. Circle the common prime factors of the given numbers. The product of the common factors of the number gives the HCF. Now, let's move on with this. Now, see. We are having two numbers with us, that is 32 and 24. We will divide that number continuously till that time when we are not getting quotient as 1. When I have divided this 32 one time with 2, 2 is the smallest number with which we will start dividing any number. So, when I have divided 32 by 2, I have got 16 as the quotient, which I have written just below 32. Now, after that again I will divide 16. With 2 only, okay? If with 2 it will not be divisible, then we will divide it with 3 or 4. But if it is divisible with 2, first we will try to divide it by 2 only. It is not like that means in 16 table we are getting 16 in one time only and we will divide it and we will write the quotient 1. That is not the correct way, okay? We always used to divide the given number with the smallest number first. Okay, if that small with that smallest which is not divisible, we used to go on. Okay, but always with the smallest we used to start. Now again, we will divide this 16 by 2, we will get 8. So we will write 8 as the quotient again. Again, we will divide this 8 by 2. Okay, then we will get 4. Then again, we will divide this 4 by 2, we will get 2. And again, last, we will divide this by 2, we will get 1 as the quotient. So, this repeated division we have done and we have got the quotient as 1 at the last. In the same way we will do with the 24. We will divide 24 by 2, that is divisible in 12 times. So, 12 I will write downside of 24. Then again I will divide this with 2. I will get 6, which I will write just below 12. Again I will divide it by 2 and I will get 3, which I will write just below 6. Then, is this 3 is divisible by 2? We can divide that number, we can divide any number with whatever number we are dividing. We have to keep in our mind also that number should divide the given number completely without remainder, because we don't have to write any remainder. It should be completely divisible. So, this 2, 3 was not divisible. So, I have divided this number by 3 only. So, 3 ones are 3. So, I have written 1 as the quotient at last. Now, my dear, I will write separately the prime factors which I have got of 32 and 24. So, I have got the prime factor, that is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. 5 times I have written 2 because I have divided this 32 in 5 times. Okay. Then, in the same way, I have written the prime factorization of 24. 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 means 2 3 times 2 and 1 time 3. Now we will see that which is the common in them. 1, this 2 and 2 is 1 common we are getting. 2 and 2, 1 common again we are getting. 2 and 2 again 1 we common we are getting. Now we have separated the common ones. Uncommon ones we will not do anything with that. We will leave it. Common ones whatever we will get with that common one we will multiply and we will get the product, and that product is only the highest common factor of 32 and 24. So 2 into 2 is 4 and 4 into 2 is 8. So 8 is the highest common factor which we have received of 32 and 24. This is also one of the way, my dear, in which we can do. Second method it is. Okay, you can do in that way also. That is also okay. That is also prime factorization method only. In this what we are doing, there we have separately divided 32 and 24. Here we are what doing, we have written 32 and 24 together and then we are dividing with the common factors. Means then we are dividing it with the common number. Find the least prime factor that divides the given number completely. Again, completely it should be divisible. Okay. The least prime. Least means the smallest one. Then with 32, then which number divides 32 and 24 completely? 2 is the number which divides 32 and 24 completely. And when we are dividing 32 by 2, then we are getting 16. When we are dividing 24 by 2, then we are getting 12. I have written 12, 16 and 12 just below 32 and 24. Now after that, second method, second step. Continue in this manner until the quotient obtained are not divisible by the same prime number. Stop the division. Means, in simple, you should get the quotient as 1 only. Or else the quotient you should get with that number which is not divisible by a common number. Okay, like again I will divide this 16 and 12 with 2, then I am getting 8. When I am dividing 16 by 2, I am getting 8, and when I am dividing 12 by 2, I am getting 6. So then after again I will divide, okay, until we are not getting the uncommon number to divide. Okay, it is written, continue this one. Okay, we have to continue this one. Quotient obtained are not divisible by the same prime numbers. It should means we will continue that one till that much time, till that is not divisible by the same prime. Means both the numbers should not be divisible by the same prime number. Then we will stop there, the division. If both are divisible with any prime number, then we will continue. Okay. So like you can see, 16 we have divided by 2 and we have got 8. Again we have I have divided 12 by 2, then I have got 6. I have written both the numbers. Then again I am seeing that this 8 and 6 is divisible by 2. So 8 we are dividing by 2 and we are getting 4. And 6 we are dividing by 2, then we are getting 3. Now is there any common prime number with which both 4 and 3 is divisible? No. No, it is not divisible. We can divide 4 by 2 and it is divisible. We can divide 3 by 3, it is divisible. But with 2, can it both be divisible? No. With 3, both can be divisible? No. With 4, no. So, we will stop our division just here only. After that, what we will do? We will see that the common ones we have to write now. We have to see the common ones. Okay. So, what are the common we have got? This we have got. 2 into 2 into 2. These are uncommon, no? So these we will not write. And then we will write, we will do 2 into 2 into 2. The same thing. 2 into 2 is 4. And 4 into 2 is 8. So we have got the highest common factor is 8. The product of the common prime factors of the number gives the HCF. So the common prime factor which we have received is 2 into 2 into 2. And we have received 8 as the common prime factor. The highest common prime factor. Okay. Again, one question I am with. We are having two numbers to find the prime factorization. That is 32 and 24. Here I have taken three numbers. 44, 77 and 110. So I will find the prime factors of all the given numbers. So I will divide the numbers I have divided separately. I have divided 44 by 2 first because we have to divide with the smallest prime number, with the least prime number. Okay, so the least prime number is first is 2. So with 2 I will divide. So with 2, 44 is divisible in 22 times. So 22 I will write just below 44. Then again I will divide 22 with 2 only because it is divisible. So again when I have divided, I have got 11. Now is this 11 is divisible by 2? No, it is not divisible. So we will divide it with 11 only. We have got the quotient as 1. In the same way we will divide 77. 77 is not divisible by 2. Okay, it will give remainder. So we will divide with this with that prime number with which it is completely divisible. So with 7 it is completely divisible. So with 7 when I have divided 77, I have got 11. I have written 11 downside and then I have again divided this 11 by 11 only. I have got 1 as a quotient. Again I will divide 110. Then 110 is an even number. So it is divisible by 2. And how we have identified that it is an even number? We have seen that unit place is 0. Unit place is 0. So it is an even number. So it is divisible by 2. So when we have divided this 110 by 2, my dear, then we have got 55. That 55 we will write just below 110. After that, my dear, again we will divide this 55 with any prime number with which it is completely divisible. So with 5 it is completely divisible. So I will divide it. When I have divided this 55 by 5, I have got 11. What I have got again? 11. Now this 11 is divisible by 11 only in one time. I will write 1 as a quotient. After this, I will write all the prime factors of all the three numbers. Prime factors of 44 are 2 into 2 into 11. Prime factor of 77 is 7 into 11. Prime factor of 110 is 2 into 5 into 11. I have received all the prime factors. After that, I will choose the common prime factors of that. Then what I will do to choose that? See. You can see I have already circled the common ones. Only one common is there, that is 11. That is only 11. So that one common only we will write, and that will only become the highest common factor of the given three numbers, that is 44, 77 and 110. Now the second method also, with that also I'm explaining you. With the second method also we can find out the HCF of the given number. We have already done in the first one, that is 32 and 24. In the same way, my dear, we will write all the three numbers together and then we will try to divide it with the common number, that 2 with the 2, all numbers are divisible. 120, 100 and 140, all are divisible by 2. When we are dividing this 120 by 2, we are getting 60. When we are dividing 100 by 2, then we are getting 50. Then we are dividing 140 by 2, then we are getting 70. Again, we will divide these all numbers by the common prime number, that is 2 only. And with 2, it is completely divisible. So we can see that when we are dividing it by 2, then 60 is divisible by 2 in 30 times. In the same way, 50 is divisible by 2 in 25 times. And 70 is divisible by 2 in 35 times. So we have written downside. Now, is there any common prime number with which this 30, 25 and 35 is divisible? Yes, it is. That is 5. With 5, these all numbers are divisible. 30 is also divisible, 25 is also divisible and 35 is also divisible. When we are dividing 30 by 5, it is divisible in 6 times. When we are dividing 25 by 5, it is divisible in 5 times. And when we are dividing 35 by 5, it is divisible in 7 times. Now, the downside number which we have got, that is 6, 5 and 7. Is the 6, 5 and 7 is divisible by any common prime number? No, it is not divisible. So in that case, whatever the common numbers which you have received, that you will write together. That is 2 into 5. Okay, these are the common ones which you have received, and the uncommon one you will not do anything with that. You will leave it. 2 into 4 is 4, 4 into 5 is 20. So 20 is the highest common factor which we have received of 120, 100 and 140, my dear. Okay, this is the highest common factor which we have received after doing the division, and then we have find out the product with the common numbers. Common factors we have multiplied and we have got the product, and that product is only the highest common factor of the three numbers. Now I am here with one more question of repeated division. What is that question? You can see this numbers downside, the steps are written. Divide the number by the smallest prime factor. Write the quotient below the dividend. Means we can see 180 is the dividend here, and when I have divided this 180 with the common prime number, with the smallest prime number, sorry, then we have got 80. We have got 90. 90 is the dividend here. 90 is the quotient here, which I have written just below the dividend, that is 180. After that, I have divided 90 by 2 again, okay, and continue to divide this quotient with the smallest possible prime number. We will divide this quotient till that much time, okay, until that we will divide when we are not getting the quotient as 1, okay. Continue the division. We will continue it, continue the division with continue the divide the quotient with the smallest possible number. With the smallest possible number, we will continue the division. So now this 90 is divisible by 2 in 45 times. I have written 45 just below 90, and then again I have divided this 45 by 3 because it was not divisible by 2, so I have divided it by 3. Then I have got 15, which I have written just below 45. Then again I have divided this 15 by 3. I have got 5, which I have written downside. Now again I have divided 5 and I have got quotient as 1. Write the number as the product of the prime factor arranged in ascending order. Then after that we will write all the numbers, okay, as whatever the prime factors we have received. We have received these all prime factors that I have will write downside. 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. That are the prime factors which I have received of this number. After getting the prime factor of that number, what we will multiply it. 2 into 2 is 4. 4 into 3 is 12. 12 into 3 is 36. And 36 into 5 you will do. Then you will get the highest common factor of this number. No, this is only the prime factorization. This is not the common, because two numbers we have not divided. Now we have divided only. So there is no common in that. So this is only just a prime factor factorization which we have done. When you will multiply these two, you will get 180 only. 36 into 5 you will do, now you will get 180 only. Okay. So this is how we have got that. We have done the division of this number by prime factorizing and by dividing it by continuous division method. Now this is how we can do the prime factorization of number by building a factor tree. Okay, how we can do? Write the given number as the pair of its factor. Means what are the factors of 180? 18 and 10 are the factors of 180. Okay, pairs of its factor. So 18 and 10 is the factor. 18 into 10 you will do, you will get 180. So they are the pairing factors. That I will write just below that. You will make the columns like this. This is the factor tree. Okay. Pair and number I have written. Now continue this process till we get all the factors that are prime numbers. You will continue this process till that much time in which you are getting the factors as the prime numbers. Okay, prime numbers we are already knowing. The prime numbers have only two factors. So continue this division, this process till that much time in which you are not getting the last prime number as their factor. Now 18, when I am dividing, my dear, I am getting the two pairs, that is 3 and 6 are the pairs of 18. 3 into 6 is 18. So they are the two pairs. In the same way, 2 and 5 is the pair of 10. 2 into 5 we are doing, then we are getting 10. After that, 3 and 2 is already the prime factors because they don't have any more factor. They have the factor that is 1 and the number itself. Rather than that 6 and 5 we will see. Okay, 5 is also having two factors, that is 1 and the number itself, that is 5. But 6 is having 3 factors. Okay, so again we will prime factorize this 6. So we will get the two pairs of 6, that is 2 and 3. We will do the prime factorization of that. Then that 2 and 3 which we have received, that we have got. Now this 2 and 3 is only having two factors. They are already in prime factor. They are already prime factors. So we will continue this process till that much time we are not getting the prime numbers. Okay. This factor 3 we have to build till that much time we are not getting the prime numbers. Write the prime number as the product of all the factors arranged in the ascending order. After that you will write all the numbers. You can write like this. You can see downside. It is written like 2, 2. This number which I have circled, that only I have written, my dear. Don't get confused. This 3, this 2, this 5, this 2 and this. I have written ascending from the smallest. 2 and 2. First I have written, then I have written 3 and then 3 again and then 5. And this is the prime factorization which I have done with the factor tree method. Okay. Here we have to, don't have to find the common factors. So this we have done, the prime factorization of this number. Okay. That's all, my dear students. I hope you all have understood both the division method, that is continuous division method, and building a factor tree method. Both you have understood. You can, according to the question, you can apply both the rule, both the process. Okay. Whatever the question is saying, if you have to do with the factor tree method, you can do in that way. If you have to do the division method and then you have to prime factorize, then you can do in that way. So that's all. Go through the video nicely. Try to understand everything. If any query problem you will face, you can come with that in the next class. That's all. Thank you, everyone.